acted just a lot of comedies.
Yes.
You're like the Lucille Ball.
That's a huge compliment.
Comedy directors.
Because it seems to me you have a real knack to get inside the comic timing of what the playwright inherently meant to say.
And I have no idea why. Why do I have red hair? It just is the color that Mother Nature gave me. And so it's the same thing with comedy. I just, for some unknown reason, understand it. And I love doing it. I love hearing an audience laugh. I love seeing the actors relish the chance to do something wacky and zany. I really love it. Since I was 10 or 11, I've been working in and around theaters. So I've always known that theater was part of my life. It was 20 years ago. Wow. Golly, 20 years ago that someone looked at me and said, "Hey, you're a director." And I went, "Okay then." And everything just clicked right into place. Many directors that I had spoken to, and I think this was one of the first clues that I was a director, commented on the fact that if I wasn't actively involved in a conversation on stage, they could see me watching and analyzing everybody else.
Oh, interesting.
Watching and observing everybody else as opposed to being into my character, I would step out of character and observe the process.
What attracted you about Game's Afoot?
Oh.
Or Holmes for the Holidays?
I'm a Sherlock Holmes fan. I really am. I have been for a long time. I started reading the Arthur Conan Doyle stories when I was in my teens, 14, 15, somewhere in there. And so that really appealed to me. Then the 1930s film style I was raised on. I was raised on Bringing Up Baby and Dick and Nora Charles and all of those characters. And so that really appealed to me.
The best comedians, seems to me the most successful comedians, make it look effortless.
That's the goal. It's always the goal.
Yeah.
You can never, if a comedian is sweating, if we're in the middle of a show and there's sweat happening, then we're not doing it right. It needs to look like everybody in the audience is thinking to themselves, I could do that.
Can you teach comic timing as a director, or does the actor have to innately find it inside them?
I believe it's like the ability to draw or the ability to play the piano or the ability to do any kind of musical instrument. I believe that there are people who can be taught to draw. I think comedy is the exact same way. I think some of us have just the gift. We were just given the gift of comedy. And other people can learn it, but it is not a natural process for them. So they have to learn, you know, if you hold for this beat, it will get a better laugh. Or if you emphasize this word, it will get a better laugh. Whereas a lot of us will just, real natural comedians, just know to hold. Or just know to pop that word. Or just know that this look is a lot funnier than that look.
Well, I think for me, Boeing was one of the funniest moments I've ever spent in the theater.
Thank you.
Yeah, it was just hilarious.
I was very proud of it. I hope to repeat it with the Game's Afoot.
You will.
Yay!